Good morning, everybody. This is Ram Prakash, finally postgraduate from the Department of Forensic Medicine, Guntur Medical College, presenting a paper titled "Spot Postmortem Revealed the Mystery of Death of Unknown Body." Under the guidance of Dr. T.K. Reddy, Professor Dept, and Dr. Ramesh Sir, Assistant Professor. An unknown body, case details. Going into case details, an unknown dead body is found in the outskirts of Serangapuram town of Guntur district, adjacent to agricultural fields. The body is burnt and is in charred condition. The police were intimated by local people. The case was registered in the crime number 22/19 under section 302-201 IPC of Serangapuram PS. The inspector of police, Nasrapet Rural Circle, being the IO, approached the medical officer of the nearest local hospital, the concerned CHE. The medical officer expressed his inability to conduct the postmortem examination as it is severely burnt. This can be shown in the picture. It was written there, "Sir, I submit that since the body is highly burnt and decomposed and the postmortem examination need to be done by the expert postmortem examination by the local doctor, civil assistant surgeon, area hospital." The investigating officer turned to the professor in HOD, Department of Forensic Medicine, Guntur Medical College, Guntur, and gave a requisition asking to come out to the spot to conduct the postmortem examination. Accordingly, the case is endorsed to one of the assistant professor and me as a team visited the scene of offense. This is the scene of offense. As it is shown here that the body is found in open fields, and in front of us there was a road which was barely used by people, means abandoned area. The body is found in abandoned area in a charred condition. Postmortem findings. Body is found in open fields by the side of a road in charred condition. A tuft of grey hair is present at back of the vertex. Body is in supine position and in pugilistic attitude. Face is totally distorted, eyeballs, nose and ears are charred in appearance, the chest cavity and abdomen are exposed, the skin over the back of the trunk are softened with presence of maggots. Here maggots are shown beneath the body. Personal belongings. All the clothing are burnt except three pieces of a green colored designed sari and a piece of petticoat. A gold colored nose stud is present over right nostril, and a 37 screw type bottle caps are present along with two glass bottles beneath the body. In the left side picture, there are pieces of clothing burnt, and in the right side picture, we see on the right side of the body, there are caps over there, plastic caps. And injuries. The scalp shows subscapular hematoma over right side and back of the head. On opening the skull, the evidence of subdural hemorrhage and over right cerebral hemisphere with reddish discoloration is noted. The neck structures show reddish discoloration with extravasation of blood in softened muscle tissue with intact hyoid bone. This is the hyoid bone which is intact. A black color heat hematoma over occipital area of the skull is noted due to postmortem burns. The skin over the body along with the burned soft tissues and show pale yellow raw area in the underlying tissue showing postmortem burns. Internal findings. Oral mucosa is black and charred. Posterior one third of the tongue show reddish discoloration. Trachea show no food particles. All internal organs are soft, pale and flabby in appearance. The viscera containing stomach, part of liver, part of both kidneys are sent to chemical analysis, and there was no blood to be preserved. The viscera is preserved to rule out any poisoning element is present. During the investigation by police, a woman missing case was registered in nearby city Vijayawada under the jurisdiction Sachinarapuram PS, and the identified and later it was identified as the same woman related to this case. The accused gave history that they were in a habit of playing cards and she used it to give a loan for interest now and then to some other people. When she insisted for repayment of around 2 lakh rupees, the accused, with the help of two of his friends from different locations, one from Pidula town in Guntur district and another from Vijayawada itself, two of his friends planned to murder her to avoid the loan amount. All the three accused along with her travelled in a car and strangulated and hit over the head with iron rod in the car itself. After that, to conceal the evidence, they went to a lone place, nothing but a scene of crime, and set a fire over the dead body by pouring petrol over her. This is the file photo, paper clipping of the case after investigation. What I had said in the previous slide, that was present entirely in this paper clipping. This was the lady of 60 years old lady. And after obtaining the RSSL report, which came clean, the analysis report shows no poisonous substance in the viscera. The cause of death is opined as shock due to head injury. Importance of visiting scene of crime. The condition of the body at the scene of crime and in and around body, what are present and what are not present, like bottles or caps, and the place of the body. It can be concluded that an integrative approach to visit the scene of crime, investigation by police officer, and examination by postmortem forensic expert can reveal cause of death in almost all cases promptly. This completes my presentation. Sir, exactly, it was a mistake to take the head injury photograph at that time, but it was appreciated at that time.